The following episode of Dad vs. Daughter is made possible by a contribution from Roxley Game Laboratory. Hello and welcome to another episode of Dad vs. Daughter. I'm Tim the Dad.
I'm Megan the Daughter.
Today we are playing Steampunk Rally from Roxley Game Laboratories.
And this is designed by Oren Bishop.
Now this is, a combination of a lot of different mechanics.
Mm-hmm.
It's a racing game at heart, but yes. You also have to have hand management, or not
resource
really hand,
management.
Resource management, mm-hmm. Drafting.
Yes.
Hate drafting sometimes.
Yeah.
What else?
Luck of the draw, really, and just roll. There's lots of dice involvement.
Because what you're going to be doing is you're going to be creating inventions that are going to fly and participate in this race.
Mm-hmm.
And along the way, you're going to have cards that you're going to add to your inventions that give you certain abilities and such. And there are also boost cards, which can do some really nasty things.
Yeah, you like those. I kind of stay away from those, honestly.
Yeah, well.
Which is kind of surprising.
Maybe you shouldn't.
Well, we'll see.
Because you can zap people, you know, with like a particle beam.
Yeah.
There is even a card that's actually called cheat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's not a good card when someone has that.
So, <Yeah. laughs> so why don't we play the game and see who's going to win this one?
All right.
The game plays 2 to 8 players, but obviously this is dad versus daughter, so it's 2 players.
Mm-hmm.
Megan, which character have you selected?
Hertha Arten.
Okay. And do you want to show that character off?
So when you pick a character, you get 2 starting cards, which can make up your machine, and you can organize them in any way you want to. I normally do it like this.
Yeah, you match the valves
mm-hmm.
together.
Because if you do it like that, then you only have, you know, different orientations on how you can build things.
Okay. And I am playing as Ferdinand von Zeppelin. So the back of the character cards are really kind of cool.
Mm-hmm.
It shows you kind of a full picture of him. And this is what his machine can look like here.
With the Zeppelin, obviously.
Yeah, it is a Zeppelin. So... just kind of talking a little bit about what each of these cards can do. These are powered by light bulbs. So we each have a light bulb token. And when we are in the race phase, we flip that light bulb and that activates any of the light bulb cards that we have. And you'll notice like on this card, it got the slash. So it's, you know, one or the other. So this one will give me either a cog or I get one movement, but I also take one damage. And this one actually just gives me one regular movement. Megan, what are your special abilities?
I only
cards?
Have one, and it's either a yellow, a blue, or 2 cogs.
Okay, let's talk about your other part of your machine. Okay, the other part of Megan's machine is the induction motor, and you'll notice that it wants the yellow, or the electrical dice, and for every value of, or factor of 3, she's going to get one movement. So if she puts a 6 die there, she's actually going to be able to activate that twice and get 2 movement. If she puts a 1 and a 2 there at the same time, then that equals 3, so she's going to get 1 movement. Now, that is how you use the machine, but the dice stay there. So you have to vent the dice off of there, and we'll talk about that in just a minute. I do want to point out some of the things on the racetrack which are going to come into play. You'll notice, you know, we have a start and the track meanders around here. We actually have a little shortcut that you can take. The icons on the board, for instance, here we have a little factory. And if we cross over through that, for every cog that we get rid of, we can gain a yellow dice. And you'll notice there's the little infinity sign. But we have a mountain there and it shows a 2. That means we will take 2 damage whenever we cross through that space. And we have a little damage wheel here, which is kind of nice. So if we took 2 damage, we start at 0, we would go 1, 2. Now, in the course of the game, we can gain basically what we call basically shields on our machine. And when we do that, whenever we gain a shield, we go in the positive direction, so we would have green numbers. If we ever get to where we would have a 4th, then we would gain a cog, and then we would move our shield counter back to 3. And it's kind of the same way. If you get a ton of damage, The damage goes all the way up to 7, yeah. Then you move to this, and that means you have to lose a section of your invention, and then you drop back down to there. Now, when you resolve damage, you basically lose a card from your invention for every damage you take. If you can never basically pay that debt, then your machine blows up. So what that means is you lose everything on your invention except for your cockpit, and you go to the back of the line. So whoever is in last place, you would go one space behind them. If you are the person that is already in last place and you blow up, you just move back one. But you know, you don't really want to lose your entire machine. That would be bad. So let's talk about the different phases of the game. We have these nice little reference cards here. So we have draft. We're each going to be given a hand of four cards, and there are four stacks of cards that you can see up here. Okay, you'll notice they have a different outline. So we have a gold, we have a silver, we have a bronze, and then we have these what are called boost cards. Now, we're going to have a hand of four that we're going to start with, and we're going to draft. So, Megan, you would pick a card that you wanted to either add to your invention, or you'll notice up at the top, you can discard this card and get two red dice or two cogs, and you'll see that each of the colors is a little different. The boost is always you can gain one of each die or two cogs. The gold, you can always get two of the yellow or electric dice or two cogs. And the silver, which is the steam, you can get two coal, or actually that's red.
That's the wind power.
Okay. So you would get two blue dice or two cogs. So what you're going to do is you're going to pick one of these, and then you're going to play that on your turn. And play is simultaneous. But what we're going to do, because it's only two player, we want to show the game off, we're actually going to take turns. It slows the game down a bit, and it's not how you usually play, but we want to be able to let you guys get a better understanding of that. So you either build or you discard. So in this case, Megan chose to build. She passes those remaining three to me, and then I get to look at them, and I'll choose whatever one I want, and I'll play that. And I'm going to be doing the same thing, because I'm going to have a deck, or I have a hand of four cards as well. So we do that, and that is the draft phase. When we finish with all four cards, then the draft phase is over, and we go on to the vent phase. So what I was saying earlier, when you have dice on those spots on your invention, the only way to clear those off and be able to put more dice on that is to vent them off. And the way you vent them off is by the use of the cogs. Now, spending one cog allows you to get rid of two pips. So, for instance, say if Megan had a 2 on there, she could get rid of one cog and vent that dice completely. Now, on the 4, she could use two cogs, which would get rid of 4 pips. On 6, she could get rid of all 6 pips. Now,
what about the even or the odd numbers?
Yes, if you have an odd number, then, like I said, you are getting rid of pips. So, you could just turn that die down to the next one. So in the case of the 5, they say if Megan had 2 cogs that she wanted to spend to vent that, then she would spend that. That gets rid of 4, and she would take that die down to 1. It still occupies the space, but she's only going to need one,
half
basically.
Half a cog.
Yeah, half a cog to get rid of that. So that is the vent. Now, the race portion is where we will roll the dice that we collect during our draft phase. And so we roll the dice, and then we would simultaneously put those to activate parts on our machine, move forward, take advantage of whatever those machines have to offer. Last, we have the damage phase. So as we are going through, and like I had showed you on the map before, so whenever we take damage, we would increase our damage wheel by 1. But in the damage phase, we look at what that number is. Now we have to account for that. So in this case, Megan would have to lose 2 parts of her invention in order to satisfy the damage. End of round, we flip our light bulbs back over if we had used them. We return any unused dice to the dice pool unless we have certain cards that allow us to basically store dice. And if that comes up during the gameplay, we'll discuss that further. Then we draw back up to 4 cards, 1 from each stack, and we do it all over again. Mm-hmm. Finally, the game signal or the game end is signaled when someone crosses the finish line.
But that does not mean the game is over and that person automatically wins.
Correct. So what do you get to do with that case, Megan?
You have one extra turn. Basically, let's say I crossed first and I ended my turn there, and let's say you were here. So we still have one more turn. Let's say you get to go first and you have four movements. So you go 1, 2, 3, 4. You'd be ahead and I might only have one. Technically, you would win even though I crossed first.
Right. It's whoever is furthest after that last turn.
Yep.
Now, Megan had said, you know, if it was my turn, like I said, this game is played simultaneously. Mm-hmm. We're playing it turn-based just to show you guys. The only time really that whoever is up first comes into play is there are some nasty cards. There is a particle beam that will shoot the other players and cause damage to them. There are a number of other cards that you can play mm-hmm. at certain times. So what we've done in my gaming group is when we move on to each phase, we simply say cards. Now, we use this, which is the draft order. You either go clockwise or you go counterclockwise. Obviously, in a two-player game, that doesn't matter. But what we do is we just kind of pass this clockwise around so we know who would be the first to act if someone has cards to play. That's just kind of how we've done it. I'm sure other people have come up with a similar way. But like I said, normally everything is simultaneous. So you'll see us just pushing this back and forth just to kind of keep track, just in case somebody has cards to play. So let's get ready to play. Okay, we're going to do our best to try to keep our invention all within the frame here so you can see that. So first thing we'll do is we'll take one from each of the stacks of cards. So
I'm building the hover jets, which is going to go there.
Yeah, that sounds cool. I am going to just discard the arachna legs mm-hmm. and get two cogs because okay. I can't build it.
That's a problem. So I'm going to discard the coal bunker and take two blue dice.
Okay, I'm going to add a propeller to my Zeppelin.
Okay. I'm gonna discard the polymerization, I think I'm saying that correctly, and I'm gonna take a yellow dice.
Alright, I'm gonna basically do the same thing. I'm gonna discard this Apogee Manipulator and get a blue die as well.
And then, I know what I'm gonna do. Do you?
Yep.
I'm gonna discard the flywheel and take two cogs.
All right, I'm gonna discard the coal bunker and I'm gonna get two blues.
Okay. So we do not vent because we have no dice to vent right now. So we're gonna race.
Yep.
So roll our dice.
So race, we roll our dice and see what we got. Whoops.
Okay then. Well, I'm gonna go ahead and use my two cogs, and I'm gonna add two pips to the cello. If we make that 4 to a 6, I'm gonna be able to move two. So move right there. And then I'm gonna use my light bulb and gain those two cogs right back. And spend one for make this blue 4 a 5. And that will let me have a shield. And I can discard a die from a slot.
Does that also give you a... Oh, that's what the other
one
is.
It's one or the other. So you can either move and discard or get a shield and discard a die.
Okay.
So I'm going to just discard that so I can have it open. And then I'm going to go ahead and use that 6 and move one and then discard that as well.
Okay.
And that will be it for me.
All right, so you're all done?
Yep.
Okay, so I have three blue dice here. And
can move 3 times
there. I can move quite a bit. I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to put those ones there and there, which is going to give me 2 movement. And then I'm going to flip my light bulb, and I'm going to take a cog.
And you also get a movement.
Well, I get a movement, but I have to take a damage.
Your bottom one's a light bulb, too. You have 2 light bulb cards, so you can move
that
for
is
another
correct.
Turn.
That is correct.
That's pretty
this
handy.
It's actually the first time I played with Zeppelin. I played with a bunch of different guys. We don't have any damage coming up for a little bit, do we?
No, not until here when we have 2.
So let's go ahead, and I'm going to go and place that 5 and get 1 more movement.
Okay.
So I'll move to there. Now, unfortunately, I don't have any yellow dice, to...
No, it's...
Or, excuse me, get rid of cogs to get yellow dice. I don't have any places to put yellow dice. That's what I meant to say.
Yep.
So, I am done.
Okay.
So, now we go on to the damage phase. We have not taken any damage.
Nope, we're all good.
Now, the end of round, we flip our light bulbs. If we had any unused dice, we'd return them to the pool.
Pass that back to you.
Pass that back to me, just because.
And drop.
Your cards. Well, this is definitely a case of hate drafting.
Oh, gosh, that's scary.
Yeah, you're gonna see why here in a minute.
Go for it, then.
Okay, I am going to discard the auger.
Oh.
And the reason why this is such a heartbreak is because we were talking about regular movement, but we have smooth movement. And if we do smooth movement where there is damage on the course, we ignore the damage. So that's always a plus. And I could actually get rid of my propeller and put that on there because when you build, you can remove sections of your invention for other sections. But I'm just going to get rid of that and get two cogs.
I know. Such hate drafting. That's terrible. Well, I've got the drive wheel.
Well, trust me, if I had a place to put it on my machine without losing my propeller, I would have.
Okay, then. That's how we're going to be.
That's how we always are.
No, that's how I am, not you. It's a difference.
All right, I'm going to take that card.
Okay, so I'm going to play the combustion chamber right up there.
All right, I'm going to discard the firebox and get two blues.
Okay. I'm going to go ahead and discard the ether tear and take a yellow dice.
I'm going to discard the flywheel and get two cogs.
Okay.
And this is the card I was talking about earlier where you can actually store dice if you haven't used them on your turn.
Okay. Yeah, I'm going to discard Greek fire and take a blue dice.
I'm actually going to install the anti-grav device.
Okay.
Right there.
All right. So now we vent, and I'm going to spin that and make this 6 of 4.
All right, spin one cog, and actually I can get rid of those two ones, which is nice. And I'll go ahead.
A lot of cogs.
Yeah, I'm going to spin three cogs and get rid of that 5, and I'm wasting half a cog.
Hello.
All right, so we're ready to race. So I will go ahead, and I'm going to place both of those threes, and I'm going to get two movement.
So you're going to take 2 damage.
I'll take 2 damage there. And I will flip this, my light bulb, and I'll take a cog.
Okay.
And I have to take that movement. You know what? I'm not going to flip my light bulb.
Okay.
Because if I go there, that gives me 3, and I won't actually blow up, but I won't have anything left in my ship.
Yeah, that's a problem. I mean, for you, not for me. It'd be good for me, but...
So I'm going to take 2 damage. Oh, that's going to be bad.
Is that it?
Oops, I actually went the wrong way. I gave myself 2 shields.
Don't do that. No. All right. You done then?
I'm done.
Okay. Let's see. I'm going to go ahead and use my light bulb and take a blue dice. Okay, let's put my blue 2 there, actually, and I'll move 1. And I'm not going to spend anything there.
Well, you don't have any cogs.
Yeah, so I mean, yeah, not going to. Now I'm going to go ahead and put my blue 5 there. And I'm going to take 1 shield and get rid of this blue dice there. And then I'm going to play that 6, which will let me move 2 times. So... 1 will give me 2 damage, which will just take me down to 0 since I had 2 shields, and that other move will tie me with you.
Okay.
And that's that.
All right, so damage.
I have nothing.
I have 2, so put my wheel back. And here's the kicker.
You're going to lose all of your extensions.
Well, I could lose that one as well, but I don't really want to. So, yeah. So these dice go back. I lose my propeller, which kind of stinks.
Yeah, that happens.
Whoops.
Though.
That's a gold.
All
right. All right, back down to my base guys here.
Drop. Okay.
I'm going to keep my card.
Oh, yeah, boost. Oh, I'm removing my combustion chamber because I don't have another spot to put this. I've got wings, so that gives me a smooth move. I had to do it.
Kind of like the wings.
I mean, I had no other choice.
Yeah.
On that, I kind of had to do something. That's a problem. You run out of, like, ways to put them on.
I'm going to keep them on.
That's a good card, too, but I can't attach that. No, I could. Okay, let's do that then. So I'm going to get rid of that drive wheel and basically just upgrade it for some treads.
Nice.
Yep. What'd you do? You kept another boost?
Yep.
Ooh, I know which one you kept. I almost kept it, but I don't want to. Okay, I'm going to discard that combustion chamber.
I'm going to do the same thing with the boiler.
Two blues. And then, I don't want that, so I'm going to take two cogs.
I'm going to install this steam vent.
Okay. Yeah, I was going to say, you probably want something there. That's a good card, though, because I almost kept that, too.
Time to vent. I have nothing to vent.
Oh, let's see. I'm okay. I'm not going to vent. I'm
good. Time to race.
Yep. Ooh, wow. Nice.
You know, sometimes you don't want high numbers.
Yeah, for some things.
Especially when you... There's an icon here. It's basically any die value, you can trigger that. So you don't want a six. You really want a one.
And then you're like, eh, whatever. Let's see. Well, I'm going to go ahead and put that blue four on my wings, and that's one smooth move, which won't cost me that one damage there. And for my light bulb, I'm going to take another blue. And not the number I was really looking for. That's okay. I'll just put it down there. Make that a five. That will give me one move and one shield. And that's that.
Yeah, I don't like my options.
That does happen.
Let's just go there on the steam vent. I'm going to get a cog, and I could get rid of a blue. And, you know, I think I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to flip my light bulb, and I will get a cog. And I will get one movement, which puts me there, which gives me one damage. Oops.
Okay, that it?
That is it.
All right, so
do I want to play anything?
Pass that to you, though.
That's what I was going to do.
Did you mess up?
Yeah, I kind of messed
you,
up.
That's
okay.
Are you sure?
Yeah, that's okay.
Okay.
I'll save them for the next turn.
All right, discard that die. Clip your light bulb back on.
Okay, this go to you.
No, it goes to you.
All right.
I just gave it to you. You're good.
Oh, damage.
I'm good.
Yeah, I gotta get rid of this.
I was good, no problem. Okay, there's that.
I've seen that card.
I've seen some of these before, yeah. There's a couple multiple, so.
So, you know.
I'm discarding, again, a combustion chamber for two blue.
I'm going to put that propeller back on that I lost earlier.
Yeah, that's pretty helpful. I'm going to go ahead and discard that flash boiler for two blue. You're keeping boost. I'm worried. I should read them more carefully. Or just straight discarding them.
I'm going to keep that boost card as well.
Oh my gosh. Crap. Okay. Do I want to keep this, or... No, I'll discard that for cogs, not dice. Yeah. I'm discarding that for cogs. The flywheel.
You know, I think I'm just going to build the galvanic brakes.
Ooh, okay.
Put that on there.
And vent.
I have no dice to vent.
Well, I guess that's kind of helpful, huh? So that would be that con, and that makes that a two. Okay. You ready?
I have no dice to roll.
Are you serious?
Yeah. It does happen sometimes.
Oh my gosh.
So, go for it.
You don't have any cards you want to play or anything?
You know, just...
Not yet. That scares me. Okay. Alrighty then.
So do I want to play cards? No.
Okay.
That's his turn.
Okay. I'm going to go ahead and use my light bulb and get another blue dice.
Oh.
Yay.
I guess I will use my light bulb.
Yeah.
And I will get a cog and I will get a movement.
I was going to say, I mean, there's got to be something you can do. Okay, that's fine. I'm going to go ahead and put my blue 5 down there. That will give me a movement and 1 damage, but I get a shield, so technically it's kind of null.
Was it blue 5, not a red 5?
It wasn't red 5, no.
If it was red 5, you'd probably be standing by.
Yeah, you know, probably.
The blue 5, I guess you can go forward.
Maybe. What about yellow? Yellow 5. They stay behind.
I know.
Who knows?
But the coolest 5 of all is what? The Mach 5.
Yeah.
Go speed racer. That's kind of very thematic, you know, with the with a race game.
Kind of is, yeah. Okay. I'm going to do the 2 and the 3, make it a 5, and I'm going to take a health, and I can remove one of the blue, so I'm going to go ahead and remove that one. Yeah, might as well. Go ahead and put that blue 6 right there. That will give me a shield. And a movement that will cost me 3 damage, which I actually have 3 shields, so that will take me to 0. And that blue 2, I'm not going to be able to do anything with, so fizzle.
Okay.
That's it.
That's it. So, okay. End of round, flip the
no
bulbs.
No damage, because you didn't do anything. There's one I want in there, but I can't play it, so I gotta let it go.
I'm just going to get 2 yellows.
2 blues. I bet you can figure out which one I want. But I can't play it. So I don't have an attachment.
But you can always replace.
I don't want to replace it, because this gives me a shield. That would just hurt me. Okay. I'm discarding for 2 blue.
I'm going to install a second set of galvanic brakes.
Ooh, okay.
I'm just going to get cogs.
Same. And I'm going to do the same thing.
That's not going to do me a bit of good. Yeah, I'm just going to get rid of that. Get a couple more cogs.
Okay. Now we vent.
I have nothing to vent.
You have so many cogs, though.
I do.
Jeez. yeah, let's do that. Will be that, and that will go down to a 5. Okay, so now we roll. It's not what I was wanting. That's all. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and use my light bulb and get another blue. Hopefully I can get the number I want. Hey, it's higher, but it works. Gonna go ahead and put a 3 and a 2 there. Make that a 5, so I'm going to go ahead and take a shield and remove a blue, and I will go ahead and put that 6 there and gain a shield and move for 1, and fizzle those 2. Can't do anything.
Okay, I'm going to play this Apergy Manipulator, and I will take a yellow die.
Okay.
And it says I can also change up to 2 dice in my dice pool to any pip value. Let's just change that.
That's pretty handy.
4 to a 3. And the other one doesn't really matter. I'm going to put a 3 here because that's all I need. And, ooh, I take that back. I'm going to change those to both 6s. 6s. Yeah.
That's what I'm going to do.
So change that to a 6, which will give me 2 red dice, which I can't use, and 2 shields. Zoot. And then I'll place this 6 here, and that will give me another 2 red dice, which, again, I cannot use, and give me 2 more shields, which actually puts me there to a cog, so then I come back down to 3. And now I have plenty of dice in my dice pool that I can't do a thing with.
Yep.
I will do my light bulb, and I will...
You can move.
I can move.
So you'll take 1 damage.
So I'm going to... You know what? I'm going to do, that's a 3 damage.
Yeah.
Area. Yep, I'm going to do this.
Okay.
So I'm going to choose to take a damage and a movement from that. So that's going to be 2 damage.
Yep.
Puts me down to 1. And then I am going to do my normal move here. Actually, take that back. I'm going to play Jump Jets, which says... I can actually vent a blue die, but I get a smooth move. also receive damage for every 5 machine parts on my invention. So I will
It'll cost you 1 damage.
It'll cost me 1 damage.
But you have a smooth move for that 3.
And gives me a smooth move. XLX. So.
That's gross. That's so gross.
That is a saying.
That's disgusting.
So that is my turn.
Okay. That goes to you.
Get rid of all these extra dice that I could not use.
And turn your light bulb back on.
Yep.
There you go. And we'll continue. I'm going to go ahead and discard the cards.
Discard for blues.
And discard it for yellow.
I am going to discard this for
cogs or blues?
Blues.
Okay. Discard for cogs.
I'm going to build the puppet value. Or valve. Puppet valve. Hello, puppet. I'm just going to discard that for a couple yellows.
Discarding for cogs. And you are up first, but we have to vent. Yep.
So I'm going to spend 6 cogs and vent those 2 yellows completely. I'm going to place this 6 on my poppet valve and get 3 cogs.
Okay.
And then I am going to play another apogee manipulator and get a yellow. Gives me a 3. And I can also change up to 2 dice in my dice pool to any pip value. Change these bad boys to 6s. And then I'm going to place a 6 there, which will give me 2 red and a shield, or 2 shields, and put there for 2 reds and 2 shields. Excuse me. So I'm going to get 4 red, which I will not do anything with, really. But I will go ahead and roll them just in case.
Okay.
And 4 shields puts me to 3. I will get a cog and back down to 3. No. You would think it would be. So let's go ahead and put a 2 there and give me 1 movement. And you know what? I'm just going to go ahead and put my 5 and 4 there for 2 more movement.
That'll cost you 1 damage.
And give me 1 damage and knocks me down to 2. I will flip my light bulb.
Are you serious?
Flipping the light bulb. I'm going to get a...
You get a movement for the bottom one.
I'm going to do the movement on the bottom, which will give me 3 more damage.
Ooh.
And then I will also... Ooh, that would be 2 damage. Yeah, I'm going to do that. I'm going to take the wheel, or the movement, and an extra damage there.
Anything else?
That is it, believe it or not.
Okay. You can go ahead and use... No, please don't.
Yeah, that's it.
Okay, I'm going to use my light bulb to take a blue dice. And that's good. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and put that there. So that will give me a wheel and a shield, which is 1, so basically null. And put that 4 there, which gives me 1 more move. And fizzle that 1.
Yeah. Technically, you would do that because the damage phase isn't until after the race, but it's okay. It evens out.
Yeah.
So that's it?
That's it.
All right. So now it's time to do damage. I've got 2 damage I got to take care of. So I'm going to lose these 2 pieces of my invention, my poppet valve and my galvanic, and one of my galvanic brakes.
I was going to say, you have 2 of them, so it's not terrible, but.
Yeah. And then I get rid of these extra dice. As far as the cleanup, flip my light bulb, get some cards. Definitely do that.
Discarding for blue.
I am going to replace my propeller with an auger.
Aww.
With.
That's not nice.
Well, get some smooth moves.
It's not nice at all.
Smooth moves. It's from a Paul Jans song from
Who?
The 80s. Paul Jans.
Who's that?
Don't need no backseat of a rented car. Smooth moves.
I don't know that one. Is that like a lost 80s hit?
Yeah, it would be.
So I'm like, I don't know that.
Interesting. I'm going to do this.
Discarding for blue.
Discarding for cogs.
Okay.
If only I needed the blue dice, I would have taken advantage of that. Or that, even.
Yeah.
I'm going to keep this one.
Okay, I'm discarding for cogs.
I am actually going to install vacuum brakes.
Okay. And then I'm discarding that one for cogs as well.
Wow. Polarized shielding.
It's pretty good, I just don't want to. I'd rather get rid of some things first.
Now, I'm not generating any yellow dice for anything. Oh no. There's another case of not getting rid of cards to get certain colored dice that I need.
You have no dice.
I have no dice at
all.
Wow. Oh man. Okay, well, I'm gonna get rid of this then for cogs.
Why
not? I can't use
it. Oh my gosh.
Well, you know what? You've talked me into it. I'm gonna use it to get rid of two reds.
I mean, you could at least place it on your one, but.
Well, I'm going to vent that.
I mean, the good thing is with your guy, you can still at least move twice with your light bulb, even if you have no dice. That's the only advantage.
Yes, but I just put that auger in there, and
you
now...
You didn't get any blues.
Did you keep the blues off me?
Yeah.
You little stinker.
Not on purpose. I needed them for myself, honestly, but... Oh,
all right. Okay, venting time. I'm going to get rid of...
Oh, yeah.
Three cogs and get rid of that yellow.
Oops. That's a thing.
It is a thing.
get rid of that. Direction.
Oh,
and
forgot to reset my damage dial.
Actually, no, I'm not. I'm gonna keep it there because I might want that for an extra pip. Okay, now I'm good.
All right, ready to race?
Yep.
Didn't roll out high numbers.
Oh, I did good. Cool. I got a 4 for a smooth move right there, which is pretty good. Gonna spend that cog to re-roll this one since it was just a 1. And I got a 5, which is pretty cool. So I'm gonna go ahead and put that there. That's gonna give me... Actually, let's not do that. This would be smarter. So I'm gonna put that there, which will give me a move and a shield. And then I will go... Put that 6 there, which will give me another move, and I can remove another blue. Then I'll put that 6 there for a smooth move, which will not have me any damage on that 2. And then I'll go ahead and use my light bulb, and I'll go ahead and take another blue, and it's a 1, which isn't going to do me anything. So that is my turn.
Okay, since... The rules say that you can actually take advantage of that anytime during the round that your invention is on there. So I think what I'll do is I'm going to trade 3 cogs for 3 blue dice.
Wait, what are you doing?
That.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
And roll those. Okay.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, and considering I had a ton of cogs.
Mm-hmm.
So let's do this. Let's go ahead and put a 4 there, which will give me a cog back and a shield.
Which you don't really need because you're getting smooth moves.
I'm only going to be able to do 1 because I got a 2 and a 3.
You could do 2. Make
oh, it 5. Yeah, you're right, I can. Good point. So there's a 6, which actually, I'm going to do this in order.
Okay.
I'm going to flip my light bulb, which will give me 1 movement for that.
Yep.
And Yeah, I got to do this. I'm going to take the damage and a movement there, which will put me back to zero. Then I will go place a six there, which gives me one smooth move, and the two and the three, which is a five, which gives me another smooth move, which I don't really care about.
So you've just triggered end of game.
I have triggered end of game. However, I'm also going to play jump jets.
Oh, you serious?
Which says after also receive one damage for every five machine parts in my location, I can get rid of. So I have actually five. So there's one damage. I'm going to vent one blue die, mm-hmm. and I get another smooth move.
Okay.
So there's my jump jets. Can't use the red, so I'm done. Damage.
I have nothing, but you have to lose something.
I have something. I have to lose something.
Might as well just lose one of your breaks.
Yeah, there's really no point in keeping any of these.
No.
You
should get rid of your auger.
I'm going to get rid of...
Nah, not that one. The other one.
I'm going to get rid of that.
You should just get rid of the auger.
And put my damage wheel back to zero. Get rid of that.
My mind tricks aren't working today.
Why would I get rid of my auger?
Because I don't want you to move.
Yeah, I know. All right. There you go.
Okay.
Is this me?
Yeah, it's you.
Oh, I have no cards.
It's you.
So, yeah. So, this is the last turn of the game. Since I've already passed, there's no more damage I've got to deal with.
Did I deal
with this damage?
You did not.
Okay, so that's an extra two damage I got to deal with.
You did not deal with that.
All right, so...
So you can lose your auger.
I'm not going to. I'm going to get rid of this right there, and I'm going to keep the auger.
Okay.
So...
I'm discarding that. Oh, you're not done. Sorry, never mind.
That's
okay.
Well. I'm discarding this because I need two blues.
I didn't get rid of that last time. You do not. You've already passed. You do not need to keep more things.
You know what that card was.
I didn't really look at it, but I should have.
You should, because I've used it in every single game we played.
That was that one?
Yep.
Crap. I should have kept it.
Yep.
Dang it. Oh, that just cost me. I've lost. Okay. Let's see. GG.
Well, that doesn't do me a bit of good. What are you going to give me? I don't think you're going to give me anything good. So I'll just get cogs.
Cogs.
Not that I need any more, really.
And cogs.
Oh, you did give me the same thing back.
Yep.
It's not going to do me a bit of good, so I'll just get cogs. Okay, venting time. So three. So that gets rid of the two, and two more get rid of the three.
Reese. Wow, that was bad. This is not a good roll at all.
This is not a good roll. I only have two parts of my Zeppelin.
Oh.
So, since I have two parts, I'm going to play Cheat, which Megan hates because I've played this all the time. And because my invention is less than two, I get two smooth moves. One, two. I can play that at any time. Place both of those there, which give me an additional two moves. One, two. Flip my light bulb, which gives me one more move.
That was just unnecessary.
And I'm done.
Welp. Okay. Let's use the light bulb to get a blue. And let's use the cog to re-roll this one. Okay. That is the best option for me to try to even get close. That's the thing. Well, I can do... Let's see. I can do these two for two moves, which will cost me two damage, which puts me at one. And then two moves there, which at least gets me there. But... Yep.
All right, so it's time to award the trophy to Dad. Yeah, playing that cheat at the end was kind of salt on the wound, wasn't it?
Just a little bit.
A little salt and burn.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Salt and burn.
But no, that was good. You got off to an early start on that.
Yeah.
And you kind of flew by me a little bit, but yeah, I was able to catch up and take advantage of some things. I hope I didn't cheat too bad.
Yeah.
All right, so let's get to what we think. Okay, Megan, I'm going to let you go first.
So, I think this game is really cool. I haven't really played that many racing games. I guess the only other one I've kind of played is Formula Day, or Formula D, however you want to call it.
Jamaica.
And, well, yeah.
Melbourne.
Well, you played it. You played more. Kind of hard, but like more of like you're actually moving.
Yeah, that's true.
So, I mean, yeah, I don't think of Jamaica because it's like a boat racing game, I guess. Not more like, you know, this with the cars and all, but I do like this game. I think I like this one out of all of the type of racing games I've played, honestly. I'm not a big fan of the other three that you just mentioned. Nothing against them, it's just not my favorite. I think it's really cool how you have the way you can customize all of your vehicles and how you try to, like, you know, manipulate them with the dice and then getting the cogs and, like, how you do the hate drafting, in a sense, with us, at least. I think it's something really cool that's definitely not a part of those other games, so I think that makes it really interesting. I do like the board. I think it's cool because you get, 8 tile pieces, so you don't use 2 of them. I mean, I guess if you can figure out a way to
I guess if you want a longer game.
Yeah, but this is pretty good right now. But
we've never used the same configuration in all the games we've played with this, yeah.
Yeah, true. I mean, we've always mixed them up.
Because we've also played on the backside, which we'll talk about.
The backside is really cool. And yeah, I mean, we'll talk about that in a minute. I do think it's really cool. I do wish, and I totally understand because of production work and all, I kind of wish all of the components were like puzzle pieces, just so, like, you know, it's just easier to fit in. But I also get it, that's going to be a cost value, and then it's kind of going to be harder to put together just because you're going to be, you know, having like the cards. So it does work in
maybe
the cards,
maybe if they do a deluxe set where
super duper
where the cards are
expensive.
Are you know, like cardboard pieces,
yeah, I
like
mean,
stock pieces, and they pop together. That'd be cool.
Yeah, I mean, I think that would be a really cool idea, but I totally understand it's going to be a cost thing, and
have,
it's just going to
have
be
little
easy.
Little indentations for you to set your dice in.
Yeah, I mean, it's just, you know, production thing, but I totally get it. The cards work. I'm not bashing that at all, just, you know, fantasy idea. Yeah.
So Roxley, we're giving you some ideas for that deluxe version, you know, when
yeah.
This is like, you know, 10 years
golden
old or whatever.
Anniversary or something.
Yeah, that'll be an expensive one to get.
Yeah, but overall I do like the game. We're normally 50-50 on win ratio.
I think I'm a little ahead.
You're okay, so 60-40, but I mean,
I
it's really good.
75,
we're always shut up, we're always close though. It's never like a total butt kicking because we always pretty much are right next to each other.
Yeah, and the very first game that I played this with my gaming group, weekly gaming group, I was horrible. I spent too much time trying to build the ultimate combo machine that I finished the race like way back here, and everybody else was
dice.
Up there.
And then you don't have the cogs and all. So, I mean, you were running out of, you didn't have the dice.
Yeah, this game, there's it definitely is
AP Brown.
Trying to find, well, not necessarily
for me,
that.
At least, I think a lot about how can I make all this work.
But it's all a balance, and
yes.
We've seen this in many other games too, where you've got to find the balance of, do I keep this card or do I discard it so I can get the dice or the cogs? Mainly the dice, because if, as you saw, there were at least 2 turns where I didn't have any dice, and I had no way of really generating any.
Or you just hate drafting so someone doesn't get their favorite card.
You do, and that's more prominent, I think, in the less players that you have.
Yeah.
Like I said, this goes up to 8. I've played it with 2 and with 3.
Never
we were supposed to actually have 6, but we had a couple people back out.
Oh, yeah.
But, yeah, the more that you have, the more then you're going to want to play simultaneous. Because, like I said, that's the way the game is supposed to be played. We just did this to kind of show off how we're doing each one of the things. But, no. I really enjoyed this game. This was kind of a one that, you know, I was interested in, but I didn't really know. And then once I played it, I was just like, wow, this is really cool.
Mm-hmm.
I like the drafting aspect.
Yeah, it's really cool.
Kind of like Seven Wonders.
Yeah.
You know, you've got, you know, trying to fit everything together. You've got, you know, kind of the almost a race for the galaxy. Do I get this card so I can play it, or do I discard it so that I can get some resources? You know, the production quality on the game is really good.
Oh, yeah, the artwork's super cool on the cards, too.
You know, the tokens are nice, thick cardboard. Now, let's talk about the back of the board, because...
Yeah, it is pretty cool.
When we're talking the artwork, and the artwork on the cards is really cool. Mm-hmm. Really like that. Even this side of the board is fine. But I think the back side here is awesome. Now, we've played this before, and... let's see, put that like that. There we go. We just didn't think that this was going to show up as well on camera, so that's why we used the other side. I actually prefer this side better.
I do too.
I think
you get used to it, yeah.
There's
more challenges.
There is more challenges because you got like these areas that you cannot stop on. You have to basically have enough movement to jump over them. Because
or
if
have enough health, especially when you get to this. You have to be able to make that jump and then not blow up either.
That is true. So you have to really be prepared for the end game there. Mm-hmm. The game, like I said, it comes with a bunch of different characters that you can be.
We've shown that off in our unboxing.
There's five female characters, yes. And there's a ton of the male characters.
Not as balanced,
let's see.
You know.
Let me grab those here a second.
They're very cool.
So yeah, I think we mentioned them in our unboxing.
We did, yeah.
We've had Nikola Tesla, yeah. Alexander Graham Bell, who kind of looks like a Snidely Whiplash dude. I've not played with Tesla. I've played with Graham Bell.
You played with
Edison. I've played with Edison. I've not played with Marconi. Have not played with McCoy. Have not played with...
Toyota.
Looks like, yeah, it is Toyota.
Toyota.
I have played with Einstein. Have not played with Carver. I know some of the guys have played with Santos Dumont. I've played as the Wright brothers. And then the females, we have Marie Curie. We have Ada Lovelace. We have Margaret Knight. And Lise Minter. And then...
my character.
Your character.
Yep, of Hertha Arkton.
But, you know, all of their starter cards are cockpits, and their other cards are all different. So... you know, there's plenty. And mm-hmm. like I said, I've not actually played with the same character more than once.
I normally stick with my person, but I mean, I will try other ones, obviously, as we go on.
Now, the game also comes with a couple other little things.
So these are your challenger space or tiles. So you can like put these on different parts of the board, especially maybe if you're not ready for the back side and you just want to kind of challenge the front side a bit. So you have like, you know, different ones like where you can spend cogs to gain the dice color. You can just add a couple more of those around the board. The rails are the discard a die shown from your dice pool to gain a movement. And you can do that to gain other cogs. You have glaciers, which will just add more damage. And you have the crowds, which are super cool. And
yeah, the crowds. And
that's on this board.
We experience that here. Where was it at?
There's some
right here.
And there's some here, yeah.
So when you pass through this area, you're going to get the number of cogs minus the number of
exposed
things that you
pieces.
Don't have covered.
Completed, yeah.
And that was really... really big. But yeah, using these little tokens here, these are nice because you can basically customize the game however you want. If you want to add more of one thing over the other, really neat. Like I said, the components, the artwork, the gameplay, really, really like that. Overall, two thumbs up.
Yeah,
excellent game.
Super good.
And this is one that you can find even at Barnes & Noble.
Yeah.
And I want to say the price point is fairly inexpensive. Mm-hmm. I want to say it's like $35. So great game to get. Really, really enjoy it. All right. So that'll wrap it up for Steampunk Rally from Roxley Game Laboratories. And we will catch you guys next time.
Bye.
If you would like to support us, you can visit patreon.com/dadvdaughter.
Like and follow us on Facebook to stay current on our show schedule, sneak peeks at future shows, and interact with us.